Mr. Arnager, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity. Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. Situation after the appearance of the Christ become worse than before the arrival of the Christ. So that's what Jesus stressed in Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, that the arid, spirited temple priest who was sacked from the temple after it was destroyed, they could not find a job. They were not worth doing anything. So then they hypocritically entered into the church of God, and by bringing Torah, written Torah, under their armpits to lure their old customers. And they found the house to be clean, much better than before. And then they bring in seven evil-spirited people under the menorah, seven kind of menorah. And they established these deans and all that system, you know, which is same as the old temple system. So the high priest of the old temple was given the title of Pope. And you can see how cruel he became. Jesus came to set us free and not to enslave us. That is why the curtain of the holiest of holy was torn from top to bottom. Top means from the temple high priest, bottom means to the village rabbi. No more priest, but we are made royal priest. Everyone has to give his own account to God. These dog-collared priests can't give your account to God. And they are just priests, and we are royal priests. Royal priests are greater than the priest, so you don't need them anymore. But the corruption came for Mammon, money. Remember, Jesus said, you can't worship Mammon and God at the same time. You will love one and hate the other. Jesus presented a living example of that one in Judas Iscariot. Judas Iscariot was having his finger in Mammon as well. He was of Judah tribe. And people of Judah tribe, they were dominating the temple. So he was well in hand with the people of the temple, which was other fold. And Jesus' fold was free of Mammon. People devoted to God only. So Judas Iscariot was giving all the information to these temple priests to earn their praises. He was psychic. Psychic people always are opportunist. So he was exploiting the opportunity to win the favors of the temple priest. Remember, this is the Trinity, that's in my description. And these are people, once born people here, you get twice born doubting, and you get sealed to serve God. And they are one with the Holy Spirit, with God, the very sons of God. No difference between God and his son, because son represents God. He is the ambassador, omnipotent ambassador of God. So at this is the Holy Spirit, the very Spirit of God. You become the spokesman of God. Your own wisdom does not count. So you become spokesman. Whatever our Father delivers, you deliver to the people. So you go logically here. You don't talk illogical at all, because the logical reasoning brings you logo, and logos is his word. Now, the Judas Iscariot was twice born, doubting. He loved Mammon, so he went down to Mammon here, seeking the praises of men. And then from here they promote to here, which is hypocrite. So those who are seen to serve God, like Thomas, he was doubting, but he was believing. They promote here, they become the, they only know gospel, they preach gospel from their heart. And if God be willing, he can lift them up to this position. You can't go beyond this of your own, and by the very grace of God you go to this position. Now, Judas Iscariot was loving Mammon as well, and that is why he was stealing money from the prosperous and spending on his own. And he took 30 pieces of silver to help them catch the real Christ, because by the time Jesus finished his ministry, all the laborers, which became his friends, friend means of equal status, they all had the same knowledge as Jesus had. But as Judas Iscariot was stealing money from the purse, and he was hand in hand with the temple priests, so Jesus then, at the Last Supper, he threw him out, "Go and get lost." And this is mentioned in the parable of the marriage of the son, in which the people were enjoying the banquet, and father appears. He found one man not properly dressed. He said, "How dare you come into the royal kingdom of God not properly dressed?" That means free of Mammon. So he was thrown out into the darkness, and so was Judas Iscariot thrown out from the company of the 12 into the darkness. So these dog-collared priests we have today, they are of the same type as Judas Iscariot. People donate money into the church. At the end of the month, he takes money out of the church purse. That is the same thing Judas Iscariot stealing money from the purse to spend it on his personal uses.
Can
I get a login? Huh? I got to write it.
Mary Bell, sir.